Have you ever wondered what our environment was like thousands to millions of years ago? Have you ever wondered how pollution or oil spills affect the health of coastal ecosystems? Have you ever wondered how oil and gas workers know where or how deep to drill? Learning to identify microfossils can help you solve these and other problems in geology, environmental science, and the petroleum industry. Geologists can reconstruct past environments using the remains of long-dead organisms, such as microfossils. For example, we know that much of Texas was a shallow ocean 80 million years ago, during the time of the dinosaurs, because we find fossils of organisms in ancient sediments that can only live in oceanic environments. Environmental scientists can examine the remains of microorganisms preserved in sediments and compare them to the organisms living today to see how human impacts on the environment have changed the ecosystem. For example, we understand that low oxygen dead zones in the Gulf of Mexico developed recently in response to increasing fertilizer use in agriculture by examining microfossils from coastal sediment cores. For oil and gas exploration, biostratigraphers examine the remains of dead organisms such as microfossils, which are preserved in the sediments as they are drilled. They use their knowledge of when certain species lived in Earth's history to determine when drillers have reached rocks of the right age to extract oil and gas. So what are microfossils? Microfossils are the remains of organisms that are so small we must use a microscope to observe their features. Some of them are single-celled organisms called protists, such as Foraminifera and radiolarians. Others are closely related to a single-celled algae, like diatoms and coccolithophorids. And others are multicellular animals, like ostracods and pteropods. All of these fossil groups have living relatives and live in marine or freshwater environments. Some are planktonic, meaning they live in the water column, while others are benthic and live on or within seafloor sediments. In this video, we'll be discussing benthic microfossils. Benthic microfossils have hard, mineralized parts of their bodies that preserve well in the sediments that accumulate at the bottom of marine or freshwater basins after the organisms die. Micropaleontologists, or scientists who study microfossils, use sedimentary records to reconstruct past environments, record past changes in climate, and determine how long the sediments were deposited. These data are critical for estimating future sea level rise, understanding the causes of past climate upheavals, and finding economically important resources like oil and gas. Microfossils can be found by collecting sediment from the bottom of oceans or lakes, coring deep into subsurface sediments, or from outcrops of sedimentary rocks on land. At Texas A&M University, many geoscientists work with marine sediments cored from the ocean floor by teams aboard the International Ocean Discovery Program research vessel, the JOIDIS Resolution. The drillers on the JOIDIS Resolution pull a sediment core from deep within the seafloor. Then a team of technicians and scientists bring the core into the core receiving platform, where it will be measured, cut into sections, and labeled before bringing the core into the ship's laboratories. Micropaleontologists on board take a mud sample from the newly recovered core, wash it to remove fine clays, and then sieve the remaining sediment with different size sieves to concentrate the fossils. They then isolate the microfossils from sediment with a fine paintbrush and mount them on slides for further study. A single spoonful of sediment can contain hundreds to thousands of microfossils. During these drilling expeditions, one of the primary duties of the micropaleontologists is to tell the science team the age of sediments the drill has reached. This ensures the crew does not stop drilling before they reach the target age or drill further than necessary. Because different species of organisms lived at different times in Earth's history, the species found in the sediments change predictably within the age of the sediment. By observing when species first appear in the sediment core and when they last appear, micropaleontologists can estimate the age of the sediments. All organisms have preferences for the types of environments in which they live, and the organisms that leave behind microfossils are no different. By identifying the species preserved in sediments, micropaleontologists can compare them to modern representatives of these living species, or their near relatives, to infer what the environments were like when the organisms were alive. Benthic microfossils tell us about seafloor conditions. For example, benthic species often live in a narrow range of water depths, which lets micropaleontologists reconstruct the history of sea level rise and fall by identifying the species that are most abundant. Ostracods and some groups of Foraminifera are sensitive to the salinity of the water, and thus micropaleontologists can use those fossils to reconstruct changes in freshwater inflow to bays and estuaries, or distinguish a marine versus freshwater environment. Species that are sensitive to differences in food or oxygen availability can also inform micropaleontologists about changes in the past. Micropaleontological methods also can be applied to monitor changes in modern environments. For example, the increase in fertilizer use in the Mississippi watershed has led to an increase in the nutrient delivery to coastal waters. The increase in nutrients causes blooms of algae, which creates more organic matter that organisms in the water column can consume. The leftovers sit on the seafloor and are degraded by microorganisms, reducing the amount of available oxygen and thus controlling which benthic organisms can live there. Learning to recognize the different morphologies of microfossils will give you the ability to determine the ages of microfossil-rich sediments and decode the environmental signals they preserve. FossilSketch focuses on two groups, benthic foraminifera and ostracoda. To learn more about each of these groups, please see the video tutorials.